Hey guys, I am back with a video redo, and I'm doing the much feared Unicron. Much feared as in A, he eats planets, and B, he's a hard freaking transformer to do. Because there's so much that really has to line up kind of perfectly in order for him to actually work, and we'll get to that. Now, Unicron is the Galactus of the Transformers world. He eats planets to kind of keep himself alive, for food, for nourishment. He is the chaos bringer, the destroyer of worlds. He is Galactus in Transformers fiction. There's a lot of kind of history with Unicron. I'm not going to get into a whole lot because really I don't know a whole lot of it because it's just there's so much. You know, there's some stories that say that him and Primus were interdimensional gods, and you know, Unicron was trapped in an asteroid. Primus kind of turned himself into a planet to fight Unicron. When he returned, Unicron constructed the asteroid into his new body, that kind of thing. There's a lot of stuff. Then there's the whole thing where the little guy kind of made them, and I don't want to get into that. I'm just not going to do it. It's a waste of time for a video this big. As a size comparison, though, we have Unicron. This is the Armada Unicron. It's the one that I have. And here we have the Cybertron Primus. You could say, you know, the brother of Unicron. Obviously, he is the little brother. He's tiny. I'm not sure which one I like more. Primus has a lot more kind of going on in terms of gimmicks and overall appeal. Unicron's big, but he's really simple, I guess you could say, compared to Primus. I would like for them to do a new Unicron toy, if at all possible, without introducing him in new fiction. I hate seeing Unicron in cartoons now. But there you go. I'm starting off in this one because Unicron is packaged this way. This is the Armada, like I said. There have been a couple of different versions. There is the Black Energon version of Unicron. Same figure, just he's dark and mysterious. Then there's the Universe Unicron, or Universe 2.0, Classics 2.0, whichever you want to call it. From what I've seen, is the exact same figure entirely. Nothing's changed on it. He even comes with his little minicon. This is Dead End. This is his little planet mode, his moon mode if you want. The Transform Dead End, I'm going to start him off real quick, and I'm going to get him back into his planet mode, whatever. Go ahead and kind of unfold him. He's all bunched up. Take his little feet, flip them forward, fold them flat, fold it flat. Then rotate this whole section, rotate the other way. And then get this arm folded down, and then get this arm folded. And you are left with a cute little minicon. He is the friend to the Chaos Bringer. He is Dead End. It'd be cute. He did the cute little ball of fun. Yeah, so there's Dead End. Oh, and there is also a Cybertron Unicron, but he's a small little deluxe figure. Definitely nothing to the caliber of what Unicron should be. But there's Dead End. Get him in the picture because he is family. He's Unicron's only compatriot, so get out of the way. This version of Unicron is the first real Unicron toy we've ever had. There was a prototype that was made for the 86 movie. That was, I guess, okay for its time. It would have featured voice clips by Orson Welles, who was Unicron in the original movie. It was okay, I guess, but it was still really bad looking. They actually showed this at BotCon recently, so you can find pictures of it online easily. This is the one for Armada. Armada, crappy show, but brought us some cool things. It brought us our first real Unicron toy. And I'm going to warn you, mine is showing signs of wear. His little wing portion back here, they don't really fit that well, but this one, it's gotten to where it is so stretched out, it won't even fit on him anymore. It just doesn't. Oh, it does fit. Oh, that's lovely. I spent like 5 minutes putting it on, make sure it fit, and it wouldn't fit, but yes, it still fits. That makes me happy now. I'm happy. I'm giddy. You just can't hear it. But here we have Unicron. Now, Unicron, the whole thing with Armada was that you gotta catch them all. You gotta catch the minicons. They're like Pokemon. They're everywhere, and there's a lot of them. Unicron wanted the minicons to kind of give him all the power. And this guy's decked out of minicon ports. You thought Megatron was bad. Unicron can hold 27 minicons in his planet mode alone, I believe. That's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 24 on this side. Yeah, so he's got like 24 spots on his wings alone. And he's decked in his cool little minicon traps. You flip down this portion of his leg here. And the instructions are kind of funny. It shows a minicon just driving in like, oh, what's this do? And then it just, ah, gotcha. So he has two of those, catch two Minicons in there. He has guts. You have to kind of slide, you have to kind of push, there's a little groove in the bottom, push this down, and it reveals his stomach can hold a Minicon, so whenever he's hungry, he just pops a Minicon in there. That's kind of cool, I think. And you could, if you have one that's small enough, you could maybe fit Minicons in his arms. I mean, it's surely possible. I know Dead End could probably fit in their fields in this planet mode. I mean, he almost fits in there now. So, you could fit Minicons in there. Dead End's going to fall over. And he has two little spots on his shoulders where he can kind of transport Minicons. Kind of cool. I mean, a lot of Minicons. I don't have a whole lot of Minicons, I don't think. Maybe I do, I just don't remember them. But there's a lot of them. Now, he has an attack mode. That's where you rotate these little sides down so these missiles face forward. He comes with 6 missiles. And then when you lock on a Minicon, so I can actually do this, it should fire all 3 at once. I'm going to have a hard time doing this because I don't want to lose everything, but let's do it off of this angle. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, yeah. It depends on how far you push. If you push it a little bit, you can fire one. If you do it good enough where it's all at once, you can fire all 3 at one time. And I'm going to try that again because I am an idiot. So, let's try this again. There you go. All 3 at once. And they all land next to me. That's nice. So there is that. He does come in handy. He does have one more gimmick in terms of Minicon ports. So, get him here. Man, you may see this nice little translucent chest area. There's a Minicon port on his back. When you put Dead End on, or any Minicon, push it in and we get a nice big gaping cannon, and his eyes light up as he fires it. So that's kind of cool. Here's what the projectile looks like. Starts off small, then it turns into a trifecta of power. And if you want, you can just kind of put that in there, you know, mid-blast to give him a giant thing in his chest. So there you go. And when you push it back in, it makes his eyes kind of blink again. So yes, his eyes do blink. And get this off real quick. There's a button on top of his head. You can activate this by either fire the cannon or when you're transforming him. I'm going to show this real quick. I think it kind of works for this. When you push his head down, you kind of push the button. It makes his eyes glow pretty well. It's a nice little effect. And also, one hand is regular gray, one is translucent. When you push the fist in, you get a fist of doom. So there you go. That's really about it in terms of his gimmicks. It's an okay figure. It's a good figure. It's not bad. A lot of gimmicks. It's just, if you are someone who likes to customize your toys, you may honestly want to just paint both hands the same kind of gray. I'm considering doing it because this thing, it's a kind of a stupid little gimmick. I don't really care for it, and it looks weird. He has one see-through hand and one solid hand. I don't get it. But in terms of articulation, he has these little skirts here that can flip up, so you can get his legs bent in a variety of poses. And can he do a split? Can he? Oh, he can! Woo! He can do that. The legs, these also fold, so you can get his legs. High-flying kick. Plié. He has knees that fold really well. A lot of ratchets in this guy. His ankles. This whole thing kind of moves. You can have his heel. This is his heel, mind you. You can bend him. You can do a few things. He even swivels. So there's a lot of poseability with his legs. The arms. They have full movement, but they kind of get in the way of his wings. They can't pivot outwards. He has an elbow. His wrist can turn. His thumb is on its own separate joint, so it bends. The fingers are on their separate joints, so they bend. You can get a variety of poses with him. His head does rotate. I thought it didn't rotate, but his head rotates. That's cool. His whole body just swivel action. This guy has a lot more poseability than I actually thought he did, believe it or not. And I kind of forgot, which I'm shocking. He has a lot of poseability. My one real, I guess, complaint for this mode is that you cannot really have his wings locked in. There are these little tabs right here that are supposed to slot into his arms. And the problem is, though, if you do this, and it's hard to keep them really in there, so just bear that in mind. Once you get them in, all the weight not only kind of pulls them back, but you have to have his claws behind his head. You saw what happened. The wings kind of come untabbed. So you can't really pose him with his wings all kind of, you know, Unicron-esque. You have to kind of get him kind of resting over his shoulders to get this kind of effect. but it's not bad. It works. So, all that stuff is to transform into his planet mode, or planet eater mode. I'm zooming out as far as I can, so we'll see how this goes. Personally, if you ask me, you may want to go ahead and pull his wings off. They will fall off on their own, and the actual planet shells will, so go ahead and pull these off. It makes everything a lot easier. Start with his hand. Fold the thumb down so it's over his fingers. I don't know if you really could see that, but fold the thumb down. Slide the tab. Slot the fist inside. Close that up. Make sure you have enough where you can actually close it. You have to have this where it's completely flush. If you have it where one side is too far in, the door will not close. So again, fist, open, store inside. And see, just an example. Well, you can't really do that one. But close this up. These little shoulder pads, you're going to swing down so this little joint is exposed. This, and go ahead and untab the arms entirely. Bring them down. You're going to open up this little panel here. Like this, it's going to fold down. You're going to fold the arms in so the spikes are going to be on top of him. So get these down. Then you're going to fold these over, and there's little slots here, little tabs here, and they're going to peg into each other. If I can actually show this on camera. I remember the last time I reviewed this guy, most of it was really off camera, so I'm going to try to fix that. But you have this little nice little macho punchy stomach, and this is where you would store the battery for his Fist of Doom action right here. It's probably just a small little, battery. It looks like it's an LR44 battery. Next, take his head, gonna flip it back. And what I do as a bonus, I go ahead and flip his horns kind of up towards him so that they really don't get in the way, and it allows you to rest his head further back. So you get this. And since you have this going, you can go ahead and bring the shells around. You're going to rotate them so they fit around his claw like this. So, rotate, and like that. You don't have to close them just yet, but they're already there, so you're good. Take his feet, fold the toes so they're the opposite, so they have this nice little action. Rotate them so they fit inside the heels. And then, come on, baby. I'm going to rotate this. His little attack missile launcher thing. So it looks like this. And you can probably guess what's going to happen next. Fold the feet so they go over the back portion. I almost pinched myself. Ow. And then you're going to rotate the whole body on itself. I know I almost said it off camera. I'm going to try not to. These joints are so kind of stiff, though. It's a little hard to transform him. But... so, there's this, and you are about done. All that's left, I'm leaving these unpegged for now for a reason, but get the shell portion locked in place. There are little tabs scattered throughout it, and you just get those lined up, and I think the shell, no, it didn't come off, okay. The first time I got this guy, the shell kind of popped off a lot, and it's kind of a hassle, but get this, kind of rest him here for now. Take his wings, you're going to open them up entirely. And the way this works is there's two separate sections. There's this end, which has just a little tiny peg, and there's this end that has this. So it's going to be like this. The way this works is this end here is going to connect to the other end. So I'm going to go ahead and do it now. It's easy just to pull these off. I wish you could leave them on, but take these. You're going to lock those in place. Then you're going to lock these in place. There's just little pegs on each side. And so you have this. A nice little ring. Hey, it's a mouth. Their lips. Okay, so, sorry. The small end with this little slot here is going to tab into the top of his shell. There's a little hole here. And the bottom one is kind of the hardest, so I'm going to do that one here. You can go ahead and peg them into the spots where they were originally. I'm glad that mine actually locks in place. It makes things a whole lot easier. But if they come off, remember, they just go back on. And they will come unpegged occasionally. That's normal. But you're going to have it where... I can show this. There is a little screw hole. Oh, my light just went off, didn't it? That's not good. There we go. It's a little screw hole back here on each side. The little pegs on this end are going to fit inside there. Once that end, you can peg his feet together. I know you can't really see it. But there's two little pegs. You're going to peg the feet together, and this holds that in place. And there are two little pegs on each side of these, on the underside, that you're going to push together. And they will kind of lock the legs into the body. But honestly, you don't really have to do that. Being that the ratchets are so tough and strong already, you shouldn't have to peg them into his body. It would help, but, you know, whatever. You don't really have to do it. The shell will continue to open up as you do all this. So all that's left now is to take these pieces, get them re-pegged together. It's kind of hard to do when everything is so tight up there. Hang on a second. I've got them resting on my knee like a little baby. Okay, so once those are pegged together, slide them inside the top section there. And these will continue to open up. So you notice when I close one, the other one opens right back up again. So took a little bit of tinkering, but I was able to get them closed. Maybe if you kind of put this down a little further than you think. Just have it fit inside. And it should look like this when it's done. Now the problem with this is when you have him in his Planet Eater mode, you really cannot pose him due to the ring. So he's forced to just feed me kind of thing. Which doesn't really work for me. And now there is a display stand offered for Unicron. It was made by Unicron.com, everyone's favorite accessory company. But from what I've heard, it is absolutely horrible. Being that Unicron's, it's a heavy transformer. He's a big guy. And you have this little plastic stand that holds him like this. Well, I've heard many, many times people about their stands breaking after just putting them on. So you may not want to go that route. May want to kind of make your own little rig where he's, you know, being suspended. So here he is in his Planet Eater mode. He looks really good from the front, really nice. He has the whole chomping effect, the chomp thing. His head is visible from the bottom, and this is kind of where people kind of dislike it. Looks great from the front, looks great. It's fantastic, super. Rotated around, we get, it's like it's just cut off. It's okay, but it would have been nice if we could have had some kind of rounded effect back here as well to be really symmetrical. But there you go. Not a bad plan mode. And as a comparison, here we have Cybertron, which comes in these nice little nifty stands. So there's how they kind of match up. So you can recreate the whole thing. Wonder how that really. And there is a little tiny mega minicon port here. I almost said megacon, but these aren't megacons. These are minicons. And this is where you can store Deadend when he's not, you know, being a crazy little moon. You can supposedly just fit him on here, but the problem is the peg seems kind of, maybe it's too big, maybe it's too small. Where he doesn't really fit in place. Maybe you tip it, it just falls right over. So you may want to actually put him. Let's see, he's barely in there. You may want to just kind of go ahead and mount him on one of the rings if you want to. Like I said, he can hold 27 minicons in this position. So figure 24 for each ring. You can have two in his little attack button, and the missiles will fire in this mode. And then you have Deadend on the front. So 27 minicons. Not bad. And the shell will continue to open up. There you go. There is a set by our friends at Ripper Labels. Here, this is not a sarcastic little thing. They've made a set where you can make Unicron more accurate. There are stickers that can... And I think it's a really cool idea. There's stickers included in one set that are both for Armada and G1. It's overall the same detail, but there's some things, like I think for in here, and I think his stomach section, where you can have cartoon accurate depictions of it, either from Armada or G1. Nice idea on their part. I think it's a really good little thing. They've also made a version for the Black Unicron. So I would say pick this guy up. He is the best and the only real Unicron figure out there. It's kind of sad you can't really pose him. It would be nice if they included a stand where you could pose him like this. He looks pretty cool. But that is it. You can lay him flat like he's supposed to be, and he can say hello. I hope you guys enjoyed this more than my original Unicron video. I definitely don't like it, and the old one will probably be taken down since this is supposedly better. I don't know. But I'm going to go. Have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care. I know. How often do I have to make an addition to a video? One thing I did leave out, because I always leave something out, is that, well... Okay, Unicron here. I'm doing this with one hand and two hands, so you have to bear with me. If you look here, you can actually fold, see those little gray panels where his feet are connected. Originally, I had mine so they were facing... I don't know why I tried to point with my finger. So they were facing where the black portions are now. And it makes it so his head is kind of easily visible. If you rotate those up, kind of like that, it makes it so his head is kind of concealed a lot better. And it may make the overall look... I don't know what I'm doing. I should have used a tripod for this. But it does make him look a little bit better. It doesn't really improve a whole lot on the actual figure, aside from concealing his head. That's it. I'm sorry I left it out. Whoa.